What's up, America? It's old Jim Bob from Jim Bob's Commentary Channel, coming to you the secret location somewhere in America. Well, I've been telling you before about Dell computers. I bought me a new Dell computer, and the damn thing ain't worth a crap. I had one, I bought it in 2007 and replaced it in February, and I won in 2007. It was a pretty good computer. Boy, this new one ain't no good. So I got on the phone, and I talked to them people. I'm not picking my nose, I'm just scratching my head here. Anyways, I call them people up on the phone, and they have me around there 7 or 8 loops over there in India and everything, and so I give it a couple of days, and I figure, well, I'll give it another try. And so I called, first I got on a chit-chat thing, and chatted over there and told them, I said, told them a story, 14 million times I've been telling my story. And anyway, they said they couldn't help me, and they gave me a phone number to call, so I called a phone number. And I told the fella right there to answer the phone right off the bat. I said, look, I said, there ain't no reflection on you, but they might as well gonna give me to a supervisor, and because ain't nobody going to be able to fix my problem. He said, well, will you please tell me, and maybe I can. And I said, sure. And so I told him about it. I told him it's old Toshiba computer in the house, and we download off that Toshiba computer. That's like a rocket. That's how Finley, he likes to get in on the commentaries when he can. And he's a dog. And anyway, so what happened was mine won't download nothing, and it's a brand new Dell computer. So anyways, I told him all that, and he said, well, no, I can't do nothing about that. And he said, okay, let me hook you up with a supervisor. So lo and behold, I'm on hold there for a while, and pretty soon this snippy little lady comes on the phone. I think she was, at least she was not from India, but she was from, she's of Spanish descent. I'm not sure. All I can tell you is she didn't have no English accent, and she's hard to understand. And this is my biggest gripe with Dell computers, is that people that got answering the phone are foreign, and they don't speak a language that I can understand, and the thing of it is that my English ain't all that good, so they can't understand me, and we got a hell of a problem trying to fix stuff. And it's just plain stupid that Dell would do stuff like that, but that's what they're doing. So anyhow, what I did was I said, well, I told her my story all over again, and she said, well, I ain't nothing I can do for you. She got right down snotty with me, and I said, you know, it's amazing to me someone made you a supervisor. I think I probably ought to change your title to stupid advisor, and just give me the phone number, and I'll call on over there. So I call on over there, and here I was back in India again. Well, this time I got a fella from India, and his name was Leonard, of all names from India, but he was Indian, but he speaks pretty good English. We had in Leonard. And wait a minute, I'm back up a minute. Little snippy customer service stupid advisor told me the only way that they could fix my problem was if I had to pay them for it. And I said, you mean to tell me you sold me a brand new computer that won't work, and to get it fixed, I got to pay you for it? And she said, that's right. And I said, well, God dang it. Then just put me on over there, I'll pay for it. So, and then that's how I got hooked up with Leonard. He's the fella that charges you to fix it. Well, Leonard's a pretty nice fellow. I liked him, and right off the bat, and kind of slows the itch. But anyways, he talked me through this kind of stuff, and we did all kind of tests on the computer. He got in my computer from over there in India, and he was poking around in it and fixing stuff and this, that, and the other. And then we finally had to do a reset up, and we reset it up and everything like that. And lo and behold, by gosh, old Leonard fixed it. And I don't know, it took a bunch of hours. It probably cost me as much as I paid for the damn computer to fix it. But anyway, we'll see when I get the bill. That'd be another commentary. Anyways, so I'm not happy with Dell. Still, I think Dell's ripped me off. Dell, you do not understand customer service whatsoever. What you're supposed to do is put people on the phone to help us customers out here, not to make us more aggravated. And now you got me all what my girlfriend told me that I've got I'm obsessed. That's what she told me. She says, you're obsessed with the computer, you need to get away from it. And I'm obsessed with it. I can't sleep because I can't get it fixed. And Leonard helped me sleep a little bit, but then I had to go back over and then Microsoft shit didn't work. Anyways, That's Jim Bob's commentary on that. Don't buy nothing from Dell, because they ain't going to help you out.